If you have the ambition to soar, it's a plain reality with Creality. What's up, guys? My name is Sam, and welcome back to Samcraft. Yes, there was a little bit of cheddar on that one because it was a cheesy intro. In today's video, we're going to be taking a look at this guy, the Creality Falcon2 40-watt diode laser cutter, full setup. How good does it do? How well does it slice through quarter-inch thick Baltic Birch? And what kind of new safety features, awesome things, and other amazing stuff can you find? Let's get into it. Assembly for the machine is done, and to use the term assembly is a little bit misleading. When you get this thing out of the box, it is mostly assembled. All you have to do is add your laser, connect a couple of tubes with your air assist, and plug stuff up. You are not going to have to get a toolkit out, follow a 20-step program to get this thing going. This machine, right out of the box, is nearly ready to rock and roll. I don't know if the assembly portion that I shot covers this, but cable management and air assist management for that tubing is the best I have seen out of any diode machine I've ever worked with. Any machine in this shop that's a diode laser with air assist, none of them have come close to the proper cable management you will find here on this machine. I can't say enough, and I would probably could talk for 10 minutes solid about how nice that is, how wonderful it is, and then how frustrating it's been with other machines to lose a job, to have a job fail, only because it's got caught on wiring or tubing. You're not gonna have that concern with this machine, and that alone is worth a lot in the world of laser engraving. My very first step is to practice what I preach and run a cutting test with this laser to see exactly what my optimal speed and power settings are for the material that is here. I have 6mm Baltic Birch plywood, true Baltic Birch plywood, loaded up into the Creality. I have my Samcraft cutting test. This is the 3 to 7 millimeters per second file. Loaded up, everything is ready to rock and roll. So come on over as we run our first cutting test to see how well it does with 6mm Baltic Birch and what my best settings are to continue on towards making this project. Awesome sauce. So the machine is done with the cutting test, and looking at the honeycomb cutouts, I think the setting I'm going to choose is 4 millimeters per second at 80% power to get through this 6mm or quarter inch Baltic Birch in one pass. So now that we have our cutting test done, we can jump into the project, load the files up, get the machine set up, and start cutting out some pieces. Let's talk about some features of the Creality Falcon2. This is a 40-watt diode laser with the capability of stepping it down to 20 watts. There is a button on top of the laser head that when you press it, you'll see the lights go from precise to normal on top of the laser. Those correlate with the power output. So normal is 40 watt, full blown. Everybody's churning and burning. You're getting the most power to your material. When you have it on precise mode, you're down to 20 watts. Now you may be asking yourself, well, that's great, but when would I ever want to turn the power down? In my opinion, you're gonna want to do that whenever you want finer detail with engraving. When you turn the power down, you're actually deactivating a couple of those diodes inside the head, and you're giving yourself a smaller spot size or dot size of the actual laser on your material. You're going to get considerably better engraving results and better, cleaner results with the lower power. This is a pretty cool feature. As I've had other CO2 lasers in my shop, they are wonderful at cutting. They're fantastic cutters, but sometimes they don't give the best engraving results. That comes down to spot size. Creality's got you covered on that front. It can cut probably as well as my CO2, at least one of them, and it can engrave as well as any of my diodes. Our job is finished, and it took right at 12 minutes to run, which is not bad at all considering the material. The surface looks really good. the proof in the pudding is going to be when I try and pick this panel up, if all the pieces fall out or if they stay put. Nice. Every single one of those has fallen through, which means we have a good clean cut. Let's check our two little rectangle cutouts. Perfect and perfect. Awesome. That doesn't happen every time. A lot of that is dependent upon the quality of material you use. So anytime it does this, is a good day in Laser Town. The touchpad on the front here gives you a couple of options. Number one is the home button. That is great. It is so nice to be able to automatically home the machine whenever you want, right here at it, instead of going over to your desk, getting in Lightburn, clicking home, and then coming back here. The other options give you the ability to move the laser head forward, back, left, and right. There is a framing option if you use the micro SD card as far as loading jobs, and then a start pause button as well for job control. This is a pretty neat add-on and it is great to have the option, but I don't personally plan on using this workflow. I guess I've just become accustomed to having my computer with Lightburn and it control, or I use it to control my lasers. I can see what I'm doing, I have all the things there I want, and I know when I click start what I'm about to do, whereas with a card and a machine like this, I have to trust my memory, which is not very good, and hope that whatever's in it is right. So, I don't know. Too many variables for me, but it's cool that they give it to you as an option, and for people with better memories, have at it. Fresh out of the laser and looking sharp. No problems at all cutting through that Baltic Birch plywood, which, if you've never used true Baltic Birch plywood with a laser, is notoriously difficult to cut. The Creality laser didn't have any problems, and that is awesome. I'm going to take this guy outside and do a clear coat finish. I mean, I guess I could paint it, but for me, I like the natural look. I like being able to see that this is a laser cut object. So we'll take it outside, spray it up, then we'll come back in and we will run our next job on the Creality laser. I also have the Creality enclosure, which is okay. I mean, it's absolutely better than no enclosure at all, but I'm not a fan of the tent style soft sided enclosures that pretty much all manufacturers with diode lasers at least have seemed to gone to. There was one manufacturer at one time that had a metal enclosure and that was the best. Since then, they're all soft sided. I understand why, for shipping and for costs and everything. But from a daily usability standpoint, or for me, in a business usability standpoint, this tent enclosure is just a hassle and gets in my way. That being said, it is still better than no enclosure, absolutely. It has a great large viewing area, which is handy, although not usually the best for video work, so sorry about that. And it has pass-throughs for cables and its own fan. So in the end, not the best, but still better than nothing, and it is functional. To go along with my love of safety with lasers and innovation with the Creality Falcon 2, they have what they call the triple monitoring system. Now this means there are three different things that this laser head itself is always doing as a job is running. First and foremost, it has an airflow meter detection. It is monitoring your airflow and will indicate with the LED colors on the laser head front whether the airflow is good, eh, or bad. Green, yellow, and red. Very cool. This is nice to let you know visually my airflow, my air assist is working. Things are going well. The second thing they have is what they call lens monitoring. It has some magic features built within the laser head to sense your lens and let you know when it's dirty and needs cleaned. That alone is pretty cool. I think any of us have been there when we're running jobs and the quality or the performance starts to deteriorate. And then we think, oh yeah, it's been a while since I cleaned my lens. With something like this, we should be able to stay on top of that more easily, or at least have a second layer of reminder and hopefully let our jobs run better and not waste material. Number three of the trifecta of monitoring is flame detection. So built within the laser head itself is a flame detection. That's awesome. Other machines I have had have their flame detections on the frame or somewhere else externally, and they have been known to go off with windows or doors and ambient sunlight coming in versus having true flames. Having that in the laser head is phenomenal. It means I can open my doors and windows while it's running and I don't get any false alarms. Well, I believe we've had a successful landing of a project here in the shop. So what I've made here are some planes. They are very cool designs. I got them off the internet and I'll put a link to that down below. They are great for kids, whether adult or younger in age. They would be cool for decorations. You could accompany this with some kind of a stand for some kind of home decor type thing or whatever you like. I finished all of these with a spray shellac finish, which is honestly my finish of choice. I like the natural wood look. I like how the dark edges do contrast, but they give it a lot of visual interest. And spray shellac is just a piece of cake to work with in general. That being said, it would be very easy to just paint these, or if you wanted to just make the raw kits, you could then give them to someone. Say you have some kids in the family, whether they're young or old, give them the kit. They could decorate it, paint it as they want, and then assemble and glue it. That's a cool option. But you could also do some kind of home decor setup. You could do a mobile where you suspend them with strings. There's all sorts of different options. The biggest takeaway is that this was all cut out of two sheets of Baltic Birch plywood, true 6mm Baltic Birch plywood, and this machine never skipped a beat. That is phenomenal. There are links to everything down below if you are interested. If you got questions or comments on anything that I skimmed over too fast or didn't answer, feel free to leave me a comment as well. Otherwise, thanks for watching as always. Take care, and I'll see you next time in the workshop. Wait, that's a car sound. What is an old propeller? I don't know. Insert plane noises here.